Hi everyone, it's Trout Lowen here with your monthly housing market report for the Twin Cities. It's the first week of December and a lot of people are in a festive mood. And if you're thinking about buying or selling a home next year, you might find a little holiday cheer in this month's housing market report. At least a little bit. So interest rates started dropping in November, finally, after peaking in October, and new home listings in the Twin Cities Metro were actually up last month compared to the previous November. That is the first time I've been able to say new listings were up year over year in months, maybe all year. I'm going to be talking more about both of those trends and what else is happening in the Twin Cities real estate market in this video. And if you stick around to the end of the video, I'll share some projections about the market in 2024. First, a little quick housekeeping. The stats I present here are drawn from the North Star Multiple Listing Service data, and although this is my December housing market report, these stats are for the month of November, and they cover the 7-county metropolitan area. All right, let's get back to the big news. Usually, I start with new listings, but today I want to talk first about mortgage interest rates. Check out this slide from Mortgage News Daily. Mortgage interest rates are at a 3-month low and have dropped below 7% for many types of loans. And economists are predicting that mortgage interest rates will settle into the 6-7% range by spring. Now that is good news for affordability and good news for a lot of home buyers who have been pushed out of this market by rising interest rates. Now let's talk about new listings, another bright spot. While the total number of new homes listed for sale dropped from October to November, that's kind of what we expect for this time of year. The total number of new listings actually increased year over year for the first time in months. Take a look at this slide. These are year over year comparisons. April new listings down by a painful 27.6%. May down 18%. June down 20%. In midsummer, we start climbing out of the hole. And finally, in November, a positive trend, a 4.8% increase year over year in new listings. And Minneapolis and St. Paul both saw almost a decrease in the number of new listings last month. Given that supply is one of the biggest, if not the biggest, challenges facing the housing market right now, this is a welcome trend. Unfortunately, not all the tidings I bring to you this December are full of comfort and joy. We also need to talk about the lumps of coal in this month's numbers. The total number of homes for sale in November dropped from 7,030 to 6,289. That's not surprising. We have a seasonal market in Minnesota that pretty much bottoms out in January. But the total number of homes for sale declined by 5.6% compared to last November. There's just fewer homes to buy. There was a little bump in new construction, or that number would have been even bigger. The total number of pre-existing homes listed for sale in the metro was down 8.8% in November compared to the previous year. Now, that's not quite as low as it was in 2021, but those numbers are pretty similar to that crazy market in 2020. What's different here is that we have so many fewer buyers than we did when interest rates were half of what they are today. And that's just making for a less crazy market. So seasonality also affects the time it takes to sell a home. The median number of days from listing a home to going pending was 22 in November, and that's just up a couple of days from October and down a couple of days from November last year. It's pretty typical for this time of year. Home sellers were getting, on average, 98.5% of their original asking price. Again, kind of a seasonal normal. Home prices have been holding pretty steady all year. In the metro, the median sales price was $370,000. That's up about 1.4% over the year. The average sales price rose slightly more, up 4.2% over the previous year. One of the reasons for that is that the supply of homes listed for sale under $500,000 is shrinking, and the supply of homes listed above $500,000 is where we've seen that growth. Check out this slide. The total number of homes for sale over $800,000 grew by 17.5% year over year. And the number of homes for sale under $300,000 dropped by 16.2%. And that's where we can really see that affordability challenge in sharp focus. Okay, now let's take a quick look at what economists are predicting for the housing market in 2024. Dr. Lawrence Yoon, the chief economist for the National Association of Realtors, shared his 2024 outlook last month. Yoon said he expects interest rates to continue to decline, but that they're going to hang around in that 6-7% range all year. Fed up with waiting for conditions to improve, he also predicts that more sellers are going to enter the market and that we can expect to see existing home sales increase next year by double digits. Buyers can expect home prices to continue to rise slowly. So that's all I have for you this month. Happy holidays to all. I hope to see you in January. Thank you so much for watching. And remember, every individual situation is different. If you want to know how these market trends might affect your plans to buy or sell a home, or if you want a more specific look at market trends in a particular city or neighborhood, or an estimate of your home's value, call, text, or email me. I'm here to help. I'll see you next year.